Employee benefits past number 19. Masterin na natin guys yung ating defined benefit plan under this topic, employee benefits. Okay? So let's go to problem number 1. Information on nasipnget na lawag entity defined benefit plan is as follows. Present value of the obligation beginning is 1.5 million. Fair value of the plan asset, 1.2 million. Present value of the defined benefit obligation, 1.8 million. Fair value of the plan asset ending, 1,310,000. Current service cost, 325,000. Actuarial gain of 100,000. Return on plan asset, 110,000. And discount rate of 5%. So ano po ang requirement ng problem natin? Compute for the amounts that will be presented in the entity's December 31 statement of financial position or the balance sheet. Pangalawa, sa statement of comprehensive income. So basically, ang pinapahanap po sa atin kapag statement of financial position ay pension liability, okay, or asset. Pag statement of comprehensive income naman, ang pinapahanap sa atin dito sa problem na to ay yung benefit expense or benefit cost and also the related OCI items. Okay, yung paper gain or paper loss na ipre-present natin doon. Okay, so ang importante dito kapag nagsasagot tayo ng employee benefits under the defined benefit plan, alam natin yung effect ng ating accounts, okay, na mai-encounter, okay, yung effects ng accounts na mai-encounter natin in relation sa ating obligation and dun sa ating plan asset. Okay, so let's go to the solutions. So, pension liability ang ating hinahanap sa ating statement of financial position. Basically, difference lang po yan ng DBO ending at saka yung ating fair value of the plan asset ending. So, sa problem given naman po yung dalawa. Okay? We have 1.8 million and also 1,310,000. Okay? So, yung difference na dalawa na to, yan po yung ating i-represent. Okay? Sa ating pension liability. Dahil mas mataas ang obligation, meron tayong pension liability. Okay? So, nakakasunod ha. Pension liability, 490,000. So, dito sa ating statement of financial position, ilalagay yan. Next, kapag sa statement of comprehensive income naman, yung benefit expense or cost. So, ano na ba ang composition nun? So, ang composition nun ay yung current service cost, past service cost, interest cost. Okay? Interest cost saan yan ulit nakabase? Dahil interest ito ay based on the obligation. Okay? Interest cost is based on the beginning of your obligation. So, interest cost is part of the benefit expense. Interest income, saan naman ito? Based on the fair value beginning ng plan asset natin. Okay? Nakakapagpabawas dahil income. Dahil ang kinukompute natin dito ay benefit expense. Okay? So, yun po yung ating composition ng ating pension expense or benefit expense, but basically, meron din pong dagdag dyan. Yung gain or loss on settlement of the plan, yung previous na discussion natin, yung ating what we call asset ceiling. Okay, na madi-discuss natin later on yon. So, kasama din po yan sa computation ng ating benefit expense. Okay, so current service cost given, 325,000. Past service cost, wala naman po, kaya zero yan. Interest cost, so saan ulit nakabase? Based on the beginning ng ating obligation. So, ang beginning ng obligation natin is 1.5 million and the related discount rate is 10% or 5%, sorry. We have 75,000 na interest cost. How about the interest income? It is based also in the beginning of our fair value of the plan asset, ang beginning naman natin ay 1.2 million. So, 1.2 million times 5% din po yung rate na gagamitin natin. Okay, so that's 60,000. But take note, this interest income, magdi-decrease po ang ating effect. In effect, magdi-decrease po ang ating pension expense or benefit expense, ang 60,000. Okay, so ano pang nandyan? We have... Ano pa? Okay, we have gain. Meron ba? Gain on settlement. Wala or loss. Asset ceiling, wala din. Bakit wala, sir? Wala kasi wala namang surplus dito, di ba? So, matatandaan natin, nagkakaroon lang ng asset ceiling na additional information kapag mas mataas yung ating plan asset. Kasi sobra, meron tayong i-refund, kumbaga. And then, maglalagay yan ng asset ceiling kung magkano lang yung ating maximum or yung limit mismo, di ba? So, wala naman. So, ang ating sagot for this pension expense or benefit expense na ipipresent natin sa ating statement of comprehensive income ay, check natin. So, we have 340,000. So, saan ulit natin ipipresent ito? Statement of comprehensive income. Okay, so sir, ano naman yung sinasabi nyo kanina na ilalatag sa OCI items? Yan yung paper gain, paper loss again, na actuarial gain or actuarial loss. So, paano ba i-compute yun, sir? Given na po yung isa na 100,000, this is in relation to the obligation. Ngayon naman, ininet na natin, di ba? Kapag OCI items, net na yan ng obligation, actuarial gain or loss man yan, at saka ng fair value of the plan asset. Okay? So, yung actuarial gain pertains to, okay, actuarial gain pertains to the TBO yan. And then, ang hahanapin natin dyan, actuarial gain or actuarial loss naman, that pertains to the plan or yung ating plan asset. Okay, so paano ulit i-compute yun, sir? It is the difference between the estimated and the actual return on plan asset. So, ang estimated return natin, na-compute na natin kanina, 60,000, di ba? Based on the beginning of the plan asset. Ngayon naman, ang actual return, asan ba yung actual return dito? 110,000 on plan asset, ay mas mataas ng 50,000. Tama ba? Mas mataas ng 50,000 kesa dun sa estimated mo. So, meron tayong actuarial gain din dito. Okay? Actuarial gain that pertains to the present value. Sorry, the fair value of the plan asset. So, we have 100,000. And then, meron tayong additional na 50,000 para sa fair value of the plan asset. Oh. Mas. Ayan, 50,000. So, magkano yan? Meron tayong i-represent na neto. Okay? Total na 150,000 naman sa other comprehensive income items. Okay? So, I hope na-gets yan ha. Actuarial gain ng DBO. Actuarial gain, fair value of the plan asset. So, let's go to problem number 2. Information on napintas entity defined benefit plan is shown below. Okay? So, the present value of the defined benefit obligation beginning is 120,000. Current service cost is 30,000. Discount rate is 10%. Benefits paid to retirees during the year, 50,000. Decrease in the present value of the defined benefit obligation due to changes in actuarial assumptions, 10,000. So, ito yung actuarial loss or actuarial gain na paper gain, paper loss na sinasabi ko kanina. Decrease in PBO, kapag nag-decrease ang PBO natin, syempre meron tayong actuarial dyan mamaya. Okay, so we have the requirement compute for the balance of the present value of the defined benefit obligation. Okay, so ano ba yung effect ng mga accounts na to? Okay, yun yung importante malalaman natin dito sa ating solutions for problem number 2. So meron tayong DBO beginning na 120,000. Current service cost, tataas ang obligation, yes, 30,000. We have discount rate na 10%. Syempre, meron dyan yung interest cost. Okay? So, based on the beginning balance ng ating obligation yan, again, 0.1. Okay? So, ano pa? We have benefits paid. Ayan, benefits paid. Anong mangyayari sa obligation pag nagkaroon ka ng bayaran? Okay ba? Benefits paid, nagbayad ka ng mga retirements. Natural, mababawasan yan ng 50,000. Ano pa? We have decrease in the PBO due to changes in actuarial assumption. So, kung nag-decrease ang PBO mo, actuarial naman yan. Actuarial gain. Okay? So, decrease ng ating PBO due to changes ng ating actuarial assumption. So, actuarial gain of 10,000. So, meron pa ba? Okay, so wala na. Basically, ang sagot natin dito ngayon para sa ating DBO ending, DBON, will be, check natin, benefits paid, interest cost, third service cost, 102,000. Okay, so this will be the answer for our problem number 2. Okay, nagigets ha? Okay, so decrease in PBO due to changes in actual assumption is actuarial gain yan. Kasi bababa ang ating obligation. So that's it for problem number 2. So let's go to problem number 3. Ayan. So problem number 3, information on squeeze bar defined benefit plan is shown below. So meron tayong defined benefit obligation beginning 120,000. We have defined benefit obligation ending 122,000. And discount rate is 10%. Benefits paid is 50,000. Increase in PB, defined benefit obligation due to actuarial assumptions. Okay, increase naman. So, alam na natin may actuarial gain or loss din dyan, 10,000. Compute for the current service cost. So, ang ginagawa naman natin dito or gagawin natin dito ay i-work back natin ngayon kung magkano yung current service cost, diba? So, given na kasi dito, diba, sinasabi ko nga kahit pabalik-balik ta rin yan sa atin, malalaman at malalaman pa rin natin yung ating current service cost dito. Okay? So, alam naman natin, meron tayong DBO beginning. Given naman po yan. Magkano? 120,000. So, meron tayong DBO ending. How much? 122,000. So, sobra lang. 122,000. And then, current service cost. Question mark muna yan. Okay? So, current service cost. Interest cost. So, based on the beginning, ilan yung interest? 10% times 0.1 is 12,000. And then, we have benefits paid. Ayan, benefits paid. Natural lang ating obligation ay mababawasan ng magkano? 50,000. So, bawas tayo ng 50,000. And then, we have increase in present value of the obligation. Yan yung actuarial, okay, increase actuarial loss naman po na counterpart. Paper loss naman yan. Magkano yan? We have 10,000 dadagdag sa ating obligation. So, ano pa? So, wala na. So, magkano yung ating balance? 122,000. Eh, 120 yung beginning. Ang hinahanap natin is the current service cost. Yan lang yan, bold. So, current service cost ang hinahanap na. Squeeze lang po natin yan. So, magkano ba ito? Okay, so check natin kung magkano yung total. Ayan. So, squeeze natin, work back natin. We have, okay. Yan. And then, 28,000. So, check natin kung tama yung 28,000 natin. So, lumalabas 28,000. So, check nga muna natin. 120,000. 122 yung dulo. And then, benefits paid, 50,000 actuarial loss. And interest cost na 12,000. Okay, tama tayo dyan. So, check natin kung babalansi tayo. So, 120. Okay, 120 plus 28,000. Plus 12,000 less 50,000. Basta natin lang. And then 10,000. So 120,000. I think medyo may formula tayo dito ngayon. So check natin mabuti. So 28,000. So basically dapat ito ay may 30,000. Okay, dapat 30,000 yung ating current service cost. So okay, so 30,000 dapat yung ating current service cost. So 122, okay, kapag nag-work back kasi tayo, 122 less 10,000 plus 50,000. Ganito dapat eh, kapag manual eh. So, 122 plus less 10 plus 50 less 12 and then less 120,000 should be 30,000 dapat ang lalabas yan. So, 122,000 is the correct answer para sa baba. Tama po yung... Okay, so, dapat ang... Check lang natin para yung sa formula natin. Dapat yung formula natin dito ay para ma-correct natin. Ayan. Ayan, 92,000 para yung ating... Okay, so, 30,000. Okay, kapag nag-work back tayo kasi 122, again, plus... 50,000 less 10 less 12 less 120,000 30,000. Okay? So that will be our answer for current service cost na 30,000. Ayan. 30,000. For problem number 3. Ah, diba? So we no work back lang po natin or ini-squeeze natin yung sagot. So, problem number 4. Information on loading entities defined benefit plan is shown below. Meron tayong fair value of the plan asset beginning, 1 million. Return on plan asset, 120,000. And then contributions to the fund ay 30,000. Obligation beginning, 1.2 million. Current service cost, 300,000. Benefits paid, 50,000. Discount rate, 10%. Requirement, compute for the pension liability or asset as of January 1 and then sa pangalawang requirement ay yung December 31 or ending balance naman yan. Okay, so let's go para sa problem number 4. Okay, so problem number 4 ang pinapakompute sa atin ay pension liability or ating asset as of January 1. So we have, check natin, given po yung ating fair value at saka yung okay, obligation beginning. So basically, madali lang itong beginning. DBO na magkano? DBO beginning na 1.2 million. And then yung fair value of the plan asset or beginning ito. Ayan, para mas okay. Okay, fair value of the plan asset beginning na 1 million. So, we have 200,000 for the pension liability asset as of January 1. So, mas mataas ang obligation. So, kung mas mataas ang obligation, pension liability yan. Okay? So, let's go to December 31 na computation. So, computation ng December 31. So, let's start with the DBO beginning. Now, 1.2 million. And then, interest cost. Magkano ang interest cost natin dyan? 10% ng 1.2. 120,000. We have current service cost given. 300,000. Ayan. And then, meron po tayong, check natin ha, contribution, return on plan asset, pension liability. Ayan. Okay, so ano pa? Benefits paid. Okay, yung benefits paid dyan ay 50,000. Siyempre, mababawasan yung ating obligation kapag nagbayad. So, ano pa? So, interest cost, current service cost, past service cost. And then, we have actuarial. So, meron ba tayong actuarial dito? Return on plan asset, DBO, current, benefits paid, discount. Okay. So, this will be our DBO ending. DBO end. So, hindi pa ito yung sagot natin, guys. Kasi ang hinahanap natin ay yung ating pension liability ng ending. Okay. So, 1,570. For the DBO ending, and then syempre meron tayong fair value of the plan asset beginning. Meron tayong 1 million. And then paano ba tataas yung ating fair value of the plan asset ulit? Meron tayong interest income. Okay? So paano ba makompute yung interest income ulit? 10% ulit ng ating beginning balance. Okay? So 100,000 Next, contribution. So, kung nagkaroon ng contribution, natural, tataas yung ating pondo. Okay, na sineset up para sa mga retirees. Magkano bang kinontribute? Contribution to the fund is 30,000. So, ano pa? So, return on plan asset. Ayan, benefits paid. Ayan, benefits paid, natural, mababawasan yung ating pondo or yung ating plan asset. So, magkano yon? 50,000 din. Parehas lang din po yan. Okay, offsetan lang. So, 50,000. And then, we have actuarial. Okay, so ano yung actuarial natin dyan? Actuarial gain or actuarial loss. So, return on plan asset, 120,000 yung actual. Pero yung na-compute natin kanina ay 100,000. So, basically, meron po tayong 20,000 na excess. Eh, kung ang interest income mo na estimated ay 100 versus yung 120,000, nag-increase po ng 20,000. So, this will be actuarial gain. Kapag actuarial gain naman, tataas yung ating plan asset. Okay, ng 20,000. Kukuha. So, that's it for our fair value of the plan asset ending naman. Fair value of the plan asset end. So, magkano? So, ang total natin ay 1.1 million. Okay, wala na tayong nakaligtahan na. Okay, current service cost, benefits. Okay, so ngayon, ang tinatanong for the requirement number 2 ay pension liability asset as of December 31. So, ang difference ng dalawa ang ating sagot. Okay, this will be pension liability pa rin. Okay, sir, bakit liability pa rin? Dahil mas mataas pa rin yung ating obligation kaysa yung ating pondo. Okay, so we have 470,000 na pension liability for problem number 4, question number 2. Okay? So, yun po yung problem number 4 natin. I hope nakakasunod pa rin. Okay. So, let's go to problem number 5. Okay, information on Mamma Mia entity's defined benefit plan is shown below. Fair value of the plan asset, January 1, 1.8 million. Present value of the obligation, 2 million. Vested past service cost, 200,000. Unvested past service cost, yun. Oh my, unvested daw. 5 years vesting period, 300,000. Current service cost, 600,000. Benefits na binayaran sa mga retirees, 400,000. Net loss on settlement of the plan. Ito yung sinasabi ko kanina na pinag-usapan natin sa theory, gain or loss on settlement of the plan. Kasi may mga instances na yung ibang retirees nakikipag-settle na sa corporation. Okay? Para sa kanilang benefit na makukuha sa company. So, ito yun. Ito yung result noon. Net loss naman dito sa problem, 50,000. So, actuarial gains, 20,000. We have return on plan asset during the period na 120,000. And we have discount rate based on highly quality corporate bonds. Basically, yan po yung ginamit sa present value, 10%. Gagamitin din natin sa interest cost and interest income. So, ang question for problem number 5 will be, compute the defined benefit cost or benefit expense for the year. Okay, so ano ba ang mga nilalaman ulit ng benefit expense natin or benefit cost? We have current service cost given 600,000. Interest cost based on the beginning balance of the obligation, 2 million. 2 million times ilan yung percent? 10%. 200,000. So, ano pang nilalaman niya? So, we have interest income. So, saan makukuha yung interest income? Sa ating beginning ng ating plan asset, 1.8 naman guys. 1.8 million times 0.1. 180,000. So, next, ano pa ang kasama dito? Past service cost. Okay, past service cost. Sir, paano to? May vested or at saka unvested? Ito yung sinasabi ng standard 19 natin sa employee benefits. Whether vested or unvested, kailangan natin i-recognize ang past service cost immediately. Again, kailangan natin i-recognize immediately yung past service cost, whether vested man yan or unvested. So, ibig sabihin, sir, 500,000 ang total ko dito sa aking past service cost. That is correct. Okay? So, 500,000 po yung aking past service cost dito. Take note of that. So, meron na akong current service cost, interest income, past service cost. So, ano pa po? Okay. So, meron tayong gain, okay, or loss ng ating settlement of the plan. Okay. So, kung nagkaroon ka ng loss, loss on settlement. Lagyan natin. Madadagdagan ba yung expense or cost natin? Yes. Magkano ulit yon? 50,000. Dun sa interest income, natural negative dapat yan kasi may pumasok na pera. Okay, 180,000 negative. So, ano pa ang ating i-consider dito? Okay, so loss on settlement. Ano pa? Yung asset ceiling. Okay, so check natin kung may asset ceiling. So, plan asset is 1.8 million. The obligation is 2 million. So, wala tayong surplus. So, wala tayong asset ceiling dyan, guys. Okay? Ano pa? Benefits paid to retirees during the period. Hindi naman kasama. Net loss on settlement of the plan. Okay na yan. Actuarial gains or loss. Sa OCI yan. Return on plan asset during the period. Para sa fair value of the plan asset yan, etc., etc. So, ang ating sagot for problem number 5 na benefit cost or benefit expense would be 1,170,000. So, nakukuha natin, ha? So, 1,170,000 for the defined benefit cost or defined benefit expense. Parehas lang po yan. Okay? So, let's go now to our last problem. Tama ba? Last problem natin ay problem number 6. Okay? So, problem number 6, information on iniwan tapos binalikan. Ayan. So, corporation defined benefit plan is shown below. So, ito na po yung effect on asset ceiling na sinasabi ko kanina. Okay? Nasa kasama dapat sa computation dahil nga wala naman. Ngayon, sasagutan natin ito. Yung number 1 ay ano yung interest on the effect of asset ceiling na i-re-recognize mo sa profit or loss statement. Pangalawang requirement, remeasurement ng net defined benefit liability or asset representing the difference between yung changes ng effect of asset ceiling and interest on the effect of the asset ceiling to be recognized in OCI. So basically, medyo magulo pero ang pinagko-compare lang dito yung change ng ating asset ceiling from period 1 or di kaya beginning hanggang sa ating ending versus dun sa na-recognize mo sa number 1. Again, yung na-recognize mo sa number 1, i-compare lang po natin dito sa changes ng beginning, from the beginning hanggang yung ending na asset ceiling. Okay? So, let's go. So, fair value of the plan asset beginning, 700. Obligation, 550. Fair value of the plan asset ending, 1.2. Present value of the obligation ending, 800,000. The present value of the economic benefits available in the form of refunds from the plan are 100,000 and 200,000 on January 1 and December 31 respectively. Diba? Sinasabi ko sa inyo na yung ating asset ceiling, para magkaroon ng asset ceiling na computation, kailangan may surplus, diba? So, ang sinasabi natin dito, dapat mas mataas, or ang punto natin dito, mas mataas yung asset kesa obligation. So, check natin. So, yung obligation ay mas mababa. Yan yan. So, mas mataas yung asset natin ng 700,000. Okay, 700,000 yung asset kesa yung ating obligation na 550. So, meron tayong surplus dyan later on. Iko-compute natin. So, the discount rate to determine as determined ng start of the year natin ay 10%. Okay? So, let's go to the solution. So, meron tayong surplus, ha? So, check natin. Fair value of the plan asset. Meron po tayong 700. Tama ba? Maduduling ako. 700,000. Okay, we have DBO. Okay, beginning. Lagay natin para hindi tayo malito. Beginning. 550,000. So, meron tayong surplus. Surplus. So, yung surplus natin, kapag sobra yung ating pondo, Kesa yung nakasetup na obligation, di ba dapat magkakaroon tayo ng refund. Okay? So, yun po yung ating concept dito. Magkakaroon tayo ng refund. Kaya lang, dito sa ating standard, nagsisetup dito ng asset ceiling na sinasabi, or yung limit. Yung limit na pwede mong i-refund, nandito yan. 100,000 sa beginning, and then 200,000 pag December 31. Nagigets. Okay? So, we have surplus na 150,000. For question number 1, kung magkano ang effect natin sa asset ceiling to be recognized in the P&L, yung interest na yan, gagamitan mo siya ng discount rate na 10%. Okay? So, yung 10%, okay, 10% ng ating asset ceiling. Okay, so check natin. Asset ceiling, nasaan na yun? Asset ceiling, 10% ng excess ng asset ceiling over the surplus. So, meron tayong 100,000. Ayan. So, magkano ang ating excess? Okay? Meron tayong okay, effect of asset ceiling na 50,000 and then ang interest natin on the effect ayan na, medyo mahaba on the effect of asset ceiling on the asset ceiling na lang, interest on the asset ceiling is 10% of 50,000. Okay, so yung excess niya, kumbaga, yung difference ng surplus at saka yung asset ceiling. Why? Kasi yung asset ceiling mo 100 lang, pero may surplus ka na 150. So may excess ka na 50,000. Hanggang dito ka lang yung limit mo 100,000. So yung effect niya, yung interest niya ay mapupunta sa ating profit or loss 0.1, okay? 5,000. Okay? So nagigets 'yan ha? Ito ay mapupunta sa P&L. Okay, interest on the effect of asset ceiling, 5,000. Yun po yung para sa number 1 natin. Eh, para sa number 2 naman natin, sir, di ba sabi nyo kanina, yung 5,000 na na-compute mo dito, i-compare mo sa number 2 para malaman kung magkano yung remeasurement. Okay, so check natin kung magkano yung ipapasok naman natin sa OCI. So, let's go to the fair value of the plan asset ending naman. Tingnan natin yung changes. Magkano ang ending natin dito? 1.2 million. And then yung ating present value or DBO ending ay 800,000. So, alam natin kaagad na meron tayong surplus. Meron tayong i-consider na asset ceiling. May surplus tayo na as of ha? As of tayo ngayon na 400,000. Okay? So, ito yung surplus natin. 400,000. Ngayon, yung asset ceiling for December 31, yung ending, okay, meron tayong asset ceiling and na 200,000. Okay? So, nag-gets ha? So, 200,000. So, meron tayong difference na. So, ito yung ating effect. Again, effect on asset ceiling na 200,000. So, take note, yung 200,000 na yan ay as of ng ating December 31. So, basically, yung na-recognize mong effect dati dun sa taas na 50,000 ay nandun sa 200,000. Okay, so, ibabawas lang po natin yung, okay, so, effect, lagyan natin, effect on asset ceiling beginning na 50,000, yung nasa taas po. Okay, so ibabawas lang natin yan to get the net effect or net change. Ito yung net change on asset ceiling. Net change on asset ceiling na 150,000. So ito na po yun, yung movement natin ng ating asset ceiling. Diba? 150,000 as of December 31 ng ating statement of financial position or OCI din. Okay, 150,000 and then yung difference ng dalawa, ayun yung ibabawas ko na ngayon yung interest para sa OCI on asset ceiling. Kano na ulit yan? 5,000. So, ang magiging sagot natin for the number 2 would be, ito na yung sa OCI, charge. Okay, charge to OCI natin. OCI. Ayan. Charge to OCI na magkano? 145,000. Okay? So, that's it for problem number 6. So I hope meron tayong natutunan to master the defined benefit plan or yung ating topic ng employee benefits. Okay? Yun lang po. Okay? Paulit-ulit lang po yan na magkano ang fair value of the beginning ng ating plan asset, magkano yung ending ng plan asset, magkano yung benefit expense or benefit cost, magkano yung asset ceiling, ganyan. So, ganun lang po. Paulit-ulit lang din po kapag na-master nyo na itong ating employee benefits past number 19. Okay? So, again, this is Jeff Ramos. Okay? Your reviewer for financial accounting and reporting. Thank you so much sa pagkikinig. I hope meron kayong natutunan sa ating hindi gaano kahabang discussion, okay? So, ng ating employee benefits. Okay, thank you so much and God bless, guys.